Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam, and today we will discuss the ultrasound appearances of placenta. The placenta is an organ that supplies blood to the fetus. It starts forming around 11 weeks of gestation age, and it is well visualized by the end of first trimester, that is 13 weeks, appearing as an echogenic structure. The normal thickness is between 2 to 4 centimeters. Here you can see small hypoechoic areas inside the placenta. These are venous lakes or placental lakes. These are normal occurrences. And you may also notice a hypoechoic layer behind the placenta. This is known as retroplacental layer. A succenturiate lobe is an accessory placental lobe which will be present in addition to the main placental lobe. Here we see the main placenta and an accessory placental lobe, the succenturiate lobe, without any connection between the two. A thick placenta will have a thickness of more than 4 centimeters, and it can occur in many conditions such as gestational diabetes, infections, placental hemorrhages, maternal anemia, or placenta accreta. In the setting of severe polyhydramnios, the placenta can be compressed and have a thickness falling below 2 cm. Then it will be a thin placenta. A thin placenta can also occur with diabetes and hypertension. A circumvallate placenta will have raised rolled edges. This raised rolled edge is known as a placental shelf. This gives it a club-like appearance. Normally, the amniochorionic membranes attach to the edge of the placenta, but in this situation, they attach on the interior surface of the placenta. Here is another case of circumvallate placenta. Here we can see the raised and curved edges. Examining the location of the placenta is very important in determining whether the patient will have a C-section or a normal delivery. Over here is the cervix, and this junction is the internal cervical os, and you can see the fetal head. This is good because the fetus is in cephalic presentation. And over here, we have the placenta that is very near the internal os. We have to measure this distance between the internal os and the placental margin. If it is less than 2 centimeters, then this is a low-lying placenta, and a C-section will be needed. When the placenta overlies the cervix, it is known as placenta previa. The first type is the marginal placenta previa. In this, the placental edge or the placental margin will overlie the cervix, but it will not cover the internal os. In partial placenta previa, the placenta will partially cover the internal os. Here only the inferior part, this part right here, is covering the internal os. In complete placenta previa, the placenta will completely overlie the internal os. Here you can see the placenta is overlying the internal os. Now we move on to placenta accreta. It is the abnormally deep adherence of the placenta in the uterus. It has three types based on its severity. The mildest form has the same name, placenta accreta. It is the mildest form in which the placenta adheres deep into the endometrium but does not invade the myometrium. The second moderate form is placenta increta, in which the placenta will invade the superficial part of the myometrium but not deep into the myometrium. The most severe form is placenta percreta, in which the placenta will invade deep into the myometrium. The first two forms are hard to visualize on ultrasound, but the most severe form has some features such as non-visualization of retroplacental layer, which is hypoechoic. Here we cannot visualize that layer. We can notice this feature around the bladder. Over here you can see the hypoechoic layer, but here it is absent. Another feature of placenta percreta is the presence of hypoechoic spaces inside the placenta. These are called lacunae. They are different from placental lakes, as they appear larger in size and have an irregular shape and are comparatively more in number. On color Doppler, we will see hypervascularity in the serosal layer, that is the outermost layer of the uterus, and usually we will see this hypervascularity around the bladder region. Here is another image showing increased vascularity in the serosal layer. Placental abruption is the premature separation of the placenta from the uterine wall. It is very difficult to diagnose it on ultrasound, as it can be confused with other conditions such as retroplacental hematomas. But it has a few features. One of them is a crescentic hypoechoic area behind the placenta with internal echoes. A preplacental hematoma occurs due to injury leading to hemorrhage, which gives us a heterogeneous fluid collection inside the placenta due to bleeding. A subchorionic hematoma can resemble a placenta, as the bleeding occurs below the chorionic layer. It elevates the amniochorionic membranes, but they have one distinguishing feature, that is this hyperechoic line. This line is of the amniochorionic membrane, and a fresh hematoma will appear echogenic. Over a period of time, around 10 to 11 days, the hematoma will have a hypoechoic appearance. This change in appearance can distinguish it from a placenta. And also another feature is that on color Doppler, the hematoma will not have any internal flow, whereas a placenta will have internal flow. Infarcts in the placenta appear as hypoechoic areas, but one distinguishing feature is that they have a hyperechoic bright rim. In this image, you can see two infarcts. They are hypoechoic and have a hyperechoic rim. One common benign tumor of the placenta is the chorioangioma. It appears as a round ovoid mass inside the placenta. Another image of chorioangioma showing a round ovoid mass in the placenta. Usually it is hypoechoic as compared to the placenta. On color Doppler, we will see large blood vessels supplying the mass. We can see both the arteries and the veins. It has a very large blood supply. Here is another Doppler image showing large vessels supplying the chorioangioma. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.